You're watching Tag. India is well known around the world owing to historical background, diverse cultures and interesting traditions. Its ancient scriptures and texts have been the way of life of its people for thousands of years. Today, the country is taking huge strides in the field of science and technology, paving the way towards a progressive India. So friends, I'm your host Surabhi Sharma, and today in our episode of My India, we will take a look at some of the stories that very well showcase the unique culture and prosperity of our country, stretching from Himalayas to Kanyakumari. Being a highly spiritual country, festivals are at the heart of people's lives in India. They not only provide respite from daily grind, but also offer a unique way of seeing the country's culture at its best. Diwali is one such grand festival that is celebrated for almost a week. By lighting lamps, candles and electric bulbs, the countrymen illuminate the new moon night sky on the festival, turning the Indian subcontinent brighter than normal days. The start of this grand celebration is marked by another Indian festival, Dhanteras. Let's take a look at how Indians prepare for this magnificent festival of light. Diwali is the brightest Indian festival. It turns every city, town and village into a fairy land with millions of electric lights, candles and oil lamps being illuminating in homes and public buildings. The beginning of 5-day long celebrations of Diwali are marked by Dhanteras, an auspicious festival that falls 1 or 2 days before the main celebrations of Diwali as per Hindu calendar. On this day, people in India worship goddess Lakshmi, who is believed to be the goddess of wealth and prosperity, according to Hindu scriptures. In Odisha, people were seen thronging jewelry shops and showrooms to buy gold, silver, brass and copper utensils and other ornaments on the day of Dhanteras.
Dhanteras jo hota hai bahut hi auspicious festival in India. Hum Odisha mein bahut dhoom dham se celebrate karte hain. Hum logo ka manna hai, Odisha vasi log ka manna hai ki agar hum us tyohar ke din agar hum kuch ornament kharidte hain, gold, silver, diamond kharidte hain, to hamare ghar mein lakshmi aayenge, good fortune aayega, good luck aayega aur jitna negativity hai wo dur jayega. Is vishwas aur aastha ke sath log buying karte hain.
People perform Lakshmi Puja or worship of Goddess Lakshmi and worship of Kuber, the god of wealth, on the day of Dhanteras. Especially Dhanteras is very important for the business community for starting new ventures and new accounting procedures. Through Lakshmi Pujan or worship, people invite the goddess of wealth to their homes that they believe would bring good fortune and prosperity in their lives.
धनतेरस की प्रथा जो है अकॉर्डिंग टू हिंदू माइथोलॉजी इज दैट लक्ष्मी का आगमन होता है तो इसीलिए धनतेरस पे लोग सोना या चांदनी खरीदना शुभ मानते हैं आई बिलोंग टू नॉर्थ इंडिया सो आई थिंक हमारी तरफ तो ये बहुत शुभ होता है हमारा लक्ष्मी पूजन वही है धनतेरस से स्टार्ट हो जाता है एंड इट एंड्स ऑन दिवाली सो ऑल 3 days आर वेरी पायस फॉर अस
After Dhanteras, people in India prepare for the grand celebrations of Diwali. They buy clay lamps and other decorative items to illuminate the new moon sky on one of the main festivals of India. According to Indian mythology, Diwali is celebrated to commemorate the coronation of Lord Rama as king after his return from 14 years of exile. In the city of Hyderabad in southern India, the onset of Diwali festivity is pulling a lot of customers to the markets. Making Diwali celebrations eco-friendly, customers often prefer buying clay lamps these days. The shopkeepers too are matching the trend among customers and they have put lamps, worship plates and other decorative items exclusively made of clay.
फैंसी दिया है राजस्थान का, जैसा कलकत्ते का, जैसा महाराष्ट्र का, गुजरात का, वहाँ से आता मिट्टी का आइटम बहुत हमारे पास सेल होता, फैंसी होना बोलते मिट्टी का आइटम हम वो लेकर के लगाए, और जग होना बोलते मिट्टी का जग लगाए, मिट्टी का गिलास लगाए, मिट्टी का बॉटल लगाए, मिट्टी का कॉट्स का दही जमाने का पॉट लगाए, हर आइटम लगाए मिट्टी का, और पूजा थाली भी मिट्टी में ही है, मिट्टी का तांबेल है और हैंगिंग का झूमर है, पूरा मिट्टी का आइटम ही होना बोल रहे, गिरा कम मिट्टी का सेल लगाए।
प्राइस तो रीजनेबल है, ऐसा कुछ नहीं महंगा
बोल रहे।
हम लोग तो ग्रैंड स्केल में करते हैं, दीपावली बड़ा फेस्टिवल है हम लोग के हिसाब से, तो ग्रैंड वैसा करते हैं, अच्छे से करते हैं।
The Festival of India not only provide respite from daily grind, but also offer a unique way of seeing the country's culture at its best. India has a great history in Sufism that evolved around 1,000 years ago. A number of Sufi saints from across the world got settled in India and spread the message of peace and harmony. Pir Haji Ali Bukhari, who came from Bukhara, the present-day Uzbekistan, is one among them. The saint dedicated his whole life spreading the wisdom of Allah, and today his shrine is a popular pilgrimage site in Mumbai and is visited by the people irrespective of their caste and religion. Take a look.
The Haji Ali Dargah is a mosque located on a small island off the coast of Worli in the southern part of Mumbai metropolitan city of India. Built in the year 1431 in memory of a saint Sayyid Pir Haji Ali Shah Bukhari, the Dargah has served as a cynosure of communal harmony for generations. Saint Haji Ali Shah Bukhari was a wealthy merchant from present Uzbekistan who gave up all his wealth to serve the humanity.
मैं यहाँ बचपन से आता हूँ, हमारे वालिद साहब हमको लेकर के आते थे, और यहाँ पे जो है हर धर्म के लोग आते हैं, और यहाँ वर्ल्ड के लोग भी आते हैं, जैसे कि क्रिश्चियन है, पारसी है, फॉरनर लोग है, हर लोग आते हैं। और बाबा का ऐसा है, हाजी अली बाबा का, कि यहाँ पे जो भी आता है बाबा के दरबार में उसकी मुरादें पूरी होती है, और लोग अपने तय दिल से आते, हिंदू धर्म के लोग आते, हर धर्म के लोग आते।
A narrow causeway of about 1 kilometer links the shore with the island of Haji Ali Dargah. The causeway gets submerged during high tides, and during low tides the Dargah becomes accessible to lakhs of visitors coming from different religious backgrounds and communities. On Thursdays and Fridays, the shrine is visited by an enormous number of pilgrims. Respective of faith and religion, people visit the Dargah to get the blessings of the legendary saint.
दरगाह जो बनी है 550 साल पुरानी दरगाह है। अभी ये दिसंबर में 552वां उर्स है हाजी अली शाह बुखारी रहमतुल्लाह अलैह का, और दरगाह पे तो पूरी दुनिया से भी लोग आते हैं, हर कम्युनिटी के लोग आते हैं दरगाह के ऊपर। नॉर्मल डेज में 40,000 to 50,000 पर डे, और थर्सडे फ्राइडे संडे अबो 1 lakh, और वेकेशंस होते हैं जैसे दिवाली हो गई, क्रिसमस हो गए, उसमें अबो 1.5 lakh to 2 lakh डिपेंड्स, और ईद बासीद तिवासीद में 2.5 lakh to 3 lakh।
India has remained the epicenter of many such sites that strengthen the bond of secularism, as people from all faiths, rising above all the ethnicities, castes, creeds and religiosity, gather at one place spreading the message of peace and brotherhood.
Now a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently. The world's most expensive chocolate was recently launched in Mumbai. Priced at 4 lakh rupees per kilogram, the limited edition try of truffle chocolates has made its way into the Guinness Book of World Records. Trinity Truffles Extraordinaire was created by luxury chocolate brand Feble Exquisite Chocolates, who are part of the conglomerate ITC Limited.
I began to work on the Trinity. I didn't really know that this product could become, could be in the Guinness Book, you see. But step by step, we chose very, very wonderful product, you see, so very expensive product. And Favels, or me, we wanted to put the best of sensation, the best flavor.
Ingredients collected from around the world, such as Jamaican Blue Mountain Coffee,
Titian vanilla beans, Belgian white chocolate, and Piedmont hazelnuts help to give the chocolate such a high price tag. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi recently interacted with Bollywood actors, filmmakers and other celebrities at an event on iconic freedom fighter Mahatma Gandhi in capital New Delhi. Modi reportedly discussed initiatives to mark and pay tribute to the legendary freedom fighter during his ongoing 150th birth anniversary year. Bollywood stars Shah Rukh Khan, Aamir Khan, actresses Jacqueline Fernandez, Kanna Ranaut, Sonam Kapoor, comedian Kapil Sharma, filmmakers like Rajkumar Hirani and Ekta Kapoor were among the attendees at the event.
Film industry can get self-obsessed, and it's important that we create work which sends out messages. And it does not mean that films should only be about messages, but in an engaging and entertaining manner, if we can involve everybody. And I think this kind of
interaction was really good.
Yeah. Very nice that all of us meet in Korean culture.
Filmmaker Hirani also presented a short film clip on Mahatma Gandhi at the ceremony featuring several actors. Bollywood actress Sonam Kapoor raised the style quotient as she presented a monochrome collection at a fashion show in India's showbiz capital, Mumbai. Wearing a short black and white dress paired with thigh-high boots, the fashion diva looked stunning as she brought the show to a close.
मैं एक black dress पहन रही हूँ, एक little black dress और it's really cute. It's very typical Carl and I love it.
The collection was all about dresses, skirts, pants, leggings, jumpsuits, mostly in shades of black and white, with a few others outfits in shades of light pink and red.
Moving on, though there is no shortage of reasons for tourists to visit Japan, but using international sports event as a way to signal that country is growing more accessible will certainly help to broaden its appeal to those less adventurous travelers. Moving on the same lines, it is currently playing as host nation to the Rugby World Cup. Along with it, Japan is also attracting tourists with its biannual art festival. We bring you a report.
This long line of people is heading towards Rugby Stadium. Japan, for the first time, is hosting the Rugby World Cup, and the competitions are held at various stadiums across the northern and southern areas of Japan. Both at the stations and towns close to the stadiums, volunteer staff is present to help visitors in taking commemorative picture and guide them to the stadium. Higashi Osaka City, also known as a rugby town, has a mascot character called Tricoon. An interesting rugby game, Georgia versus Fiji, was played at this town.
Fiji will win!
Nah,
Fiji,
Georgia,
Fiji,
Georgia,
Fiji.
Georgia!
Okay, thank you so much.
Hanazono Rugby Stadium is known as a rugby holy land in Japan, as a high school rugby tournament that has great history is held here every year. Despite a weekday, the stadium was crowded with visitors both from Japan and abroad. Though the Japan team was not playing, but still a number of Japanese supporters got crowded here.
Very good. Every time people always come up to us saying, are you here for the World Cup, and ask for pictures, so it's very good, very good.
Revitalizing hosting venues and using a number of possible locations in Japan was one of the main components of the Rugby World Cup. Moreover, a pre-game training site was also offered to each team using the stadium in a city. This is a Fiji bar restaurant in Osaka where many spectators gather after the game. Both Japanese and foreign visitors talk about rugby here to deepen their knowledge about the game.
Japanese people are really nice, really friendly, and a great atmosphere. Many of the stadiums are packed, full, tickets sold out. And I think the foreigners, Japanese, all are enjoying together. A great atmosphere for rugby.
Rugby World Cup has been organized before Tokyo 2020 Olympic Games, and many Japanese people are excited both to enjoy the games and have an international exchange with foreign tourists. Next, we take you to the Tokyo's biannual art festival, Design Festa, in which over 12,000 artists gathered to showcase their art. Known for its cultural and art museums, Tokyo hosts a number of festivals where working professionals and amateurs can show their artwork, and Design Festa is one among them. Many visitors come to this festival to see the diverse art, design and craft of the exhibitors. While few exhibitors were dressed up in different costumes, few depicted a playful nature with visitors. Presenting a new take on Japanese art, artists also gave live painting demonstrations.
結構たくさん美大生の方がいっぱい来ると思うので、その塗装っていうと結構まだ美大生の方と職の
festival is held in a large exhibition hall that remains packed with as many as 2,000 booths, 6,000 exhibitors in the summer and 5,000 booths and 18,000 exhibitors in the spring and autumn at a larger exhibit hall. Besides Japanese artists, there are international artists who also exhibit their work. Some artists are developing the community in Japan.
So I'm still pretty recent. It's only been like 5 years since I've been an independent illustrator. So I kind of have two different jobs as an artist. I have my own project, like this one, with exhibitions, conventions. So I do my own stuff, and then I work for clients in Japan or in France, anywhere in the world, for their own projects, basically. So here it's really to show up my work.
There are many things visitors can do at the festival. There are booths where visitors can participate in art and craft. At one booth, one could make a traditional Japanese fan. Artists get inspired with the creativity showcased during the festival.
やっぱり毎回毎回いろんな方々がいて、だからやっぱり自分も出展してても面白いし、ちょっと見出してみたりして、ちょっといろんな所見てみても、ああなんかすごいこういうの作ってる人、ああいうの作ってる人がいるっていうのをすごい実感できて、やっぱ創作意欲もすごい湧くし、やっぱこういう形でいろんな人たちとものづくりを共有して高め合っていいものをこの世に残していけるといいと思います。
Visitors enjoy this indoor festival and its performances given by musicians and comedians throughout the day. Instead of a comfortable air-conditioned space, this event is filled with a lot of enthusiasm and fervor.
Regarded as the richest reservoir of Sufism in South Asia, Jammu and Kashmir has remained the abode of Sufis and saints for centuries. The message of peace and brotherhood that these Sufi saints propagated throughout their lives still resounds in every nook and corner of the region, prompting people of all faiths to live in harmony.
Popularly known as Peer Vair, or El Cove of Sufis and Saints, Jammu and Kashmir tasted the sweetness of Sufism nearly 700 years back, when it had reached the pinnacle of its development. With its eclectic emphasis on mutual tolerance and peaceful coexistence, it started forming an integral part of the people ethos and guiding their lives. Today, Sufism has got itself entrenched at the center of cultural and spiritual life of the state, especially the Kashmir Valley.
Kashmir ka dusra naam agar hum dekhen sufiyat hai. Kashmir sufism ka ek gehwara hai. Jo Kashmir ye wahi Kashmir hai jisme bahut sare mazahib ke log rahe hain aur unme sanatan sant aur sufis faqirs walis uthe hain aur usi wadi ka naam sufism hai. ये यही सूफिज़्म है जो पूरी दुनिया को मोहब्बत की मोहब्बत का पैगाम देता है. लव बियॉन्ड एनी रिलीजन, किसी मज़हब किसी मिल्लत के आगे, क्योंकि मोहब्बत का कोई मज़हब नहीं होता. सूफियत उसका एक मम्मा है.
मीर सैयद अली अमदानी, पॉपुलरली नोन एज शाह अमदान, a Persian Sufi of the Kubravia order, is believed to be the first saint who visited Kashmir along with his 700 followers to preach Sufism. They then got settled in different parts of the Kashmir Valley and spread the message of love and humanity among all. Later, as a mark of respect, shrines were constructed at the places where these saints used to meditate or where they lie buried. It is said that these shrines have so much blissful air that one feels very close to Almighty inside them, and it's the reason that people irrespective of their religion throng these holy sites.
Sahi rasta dekho awliya Allah sirf hame yahi sikhate hai Allah ek hai uska kehna mano uske baaton par chalo Nabi Pak sallallahu alaihi wasallam ke raaste par chalo सही दीन पर चलो, झगड़ा मत करो, फितना मत फंसाओ. बस इन लोगों का यही काम है, बस शिर्क से बेजार रहो, शिर्क मत करो, गैबत मत करो. सही रास्ता दिखाने के लिए ये लोग हमें यहाँ आए.
Today, Kashmir is known for its love and brotherhood among different faiths, but it's all due to Sufism that inculcated the spirit amongst the people.
This month, India celebrated 150th birth anniversary of Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi. Revered as Mahatma throughout the world, Gandhi, along with spearheading the freedom movement for India, promoted khadi handlooms in order to boycott import of foreign clothes and urged Indians to become self-reliant on Indian handloom industries. Paying a tribute to the father of the nation, a fashion show named Desi Walk was organized in the Mangaluru city to promote khadi handlooms in India. Take a look. Celebrating the 150th birth anniversary month of father of the nation, Mahatma Gandhi, a unique initiative was undertaken in Mangaluru city of Karnataka. To promote the handloom industry and to bring khadi, a hand-woven natural fiber, to limelight, a fashion show named Desi Walk was organized in the city.
This program is for to attract our youth towards our desi product. Desi means it's a natural health products, khadi, kaimag, handlooms, it's called handlooms, and organic, and some home products, homemade products, we are attracting the people.
Showcasing different lifestyles and traditional attires of the people in India, models walk the ramp with great panache. The highlight of the show was commoners walking the ramp, showcasing their lifestyles and traditional khadi attires they prefer wearing while on job. Adding to the celebration, children also walked the ramp in their khadi attires, catching attention of visitors who were present at the event.
Around 1,000 people are witnessing the show now. So all we requested to wear the khadi, and we are asking them to wear, buy the product. This is a 1 year project we have done for Mahatma Gandhi's 150 years celebration. So this will go on to the next we have planned to do in Udupi and Davanagere, Shivamogga and Bangalore. So, okay. Then apart from the fashion show, we are organizing awareness programs. So within next week, we are organizing in the university or college and software companies. We approach many of the companies to give awareness about the natural product and desi product to the employees.
Whole environment was suffused with smiles and cheers. The visitors were seen amazed with performance of models and were euphoric to see traditional khadi attires coming into trend again. Apart from Bengaluru, the organizers of this event would take Desi Walk fashion show to other parts of India, also to promote khadi handloom industry in the country.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at suggest.myindia@gmail.com. I'm your host, Surbhi Sharma, and it's a goodbye from the entire production team.
You're watching Tag.